In November of 1957, police in the small town of Plainfield, Wisconsin, were searching for a missing woman named Bernice Worden. They were about to make one of the most gruesome discoveries in U.S. criminal history. This is the story of Ed Gein. Ed grew up in Plainfield, Wisconsin, of August 27th, 1906. His father, George Gein, was an alcoholic, and his mother, Augusta, was abusive. They had a poor marriage, and he lived with a brother named Henry.
Ed's family had a small town, which was bought by his mother, and they worked tirelessly so they could make enough money to make a living. Their community was really small, and everyone kind of knew each other, so that's what made Ed stand out among others.
So while Ed's father was an alcoholic, his mom despised him, and she wanted to get a divorce, but her Lutheran beliefs wouldn't allow her to do so.
Where's the food?
It's coming!
But also because of her Lutheran beliefs, she taught Ed a lot of tough lessons that not a lot of other kids got.
You are not to like any woman. They are nothing but prostitutes and instruments of the devil.
She taught him that women were terrible and that she really didn't want him to make any friends, and she'd punish him if she did so.
Hey Mom, I made a friend today at school.
Scream, you ungrateful child.
Despite all the abuse, Ed still loved his mom very deeply. She meant a lot to him, and growing up, since he had no friends, they were very close together.
How was Ed during school?
Normally he did pretty well.
Was there any sort of odd behavior or weird things that he did?
Yeah, a lot of the time he would just laugh randomly in class. He didn't really have any friends and he would just talk to himself most of the time.
Ed had always idolized his mother, even to a point where his brother was really concerned about him. And this really took him to heart when she died in 1945.
After his mom's death, his mental health started decreasing. He had no children and he wasn't married. He lived alone and he kept his house a mess, but he kept his mom's room intact.
Shortly after Ed's mom died, their family farmhouse burned down in 1958, and Henry's body was recovered from the fire with bruises all around his head. While many people believe that Ed had something to do with his brother's death, it was ruled an accident.
When Bernice Worden went missing, a lot of people suspected that Ed had something to do with it, but he would say a lot of weird things like, oh, she's just back up at the house, so... People already knew that he was weird, so they didn't think much of it until police searched his house, which uncovered a lot of horrible things. Ed attracted attention of police in 1957 when a hardware store owner named Bernice Worden went missing. Her body was later found by police at his farm, shot and decapitated and hanging upside down in a shed. After examining his home, investigators found that he had been robbing graves and collecting body parts from 40 different corpses.
Yep.
Also, they discovered the head of Mary Hogan, a tavern operator who disappeared a couple years earlier.
Ed started robbing graves shortly after his mother's death. The reason he started doing so is because he collected the body parts and wanted to make a woman suit out of the body parts so he could look like his mother. Also, the victims that he chose in his crimes, the woman that he killed, he admitted that he picked them because they resembled his mom, and that he killed them and tried to collect their body parts because of it.
When Bernice Worden went missing, Ed Gein was reportedly the last person seen with her, as he was the last person to buy stuff at her hardware store. So police searched his house, and that's when everything went downhill for Ed.
Thank you.
Ed didn't try to resist arrest or anything like that, and he happily went with police officers after they caught him. He also cooperated with them and showed them the 40 graves that he robbed, and basically bragged about all the body parts he was able to steal.
Alright, buddy, let's go. You're under arrest.
Ed entered a plea of not guilty because of insanity. He was found mentally incompetent and was unfit to stand trial.
Even though he was deemed incompetent at his trial, he was found guilty of first-degree murder. He was also diagnosed with schizophrenia and sentenced to life in a mental hospital. He was sent to Central State Hospital for the mentally insane, and he spent the rest of his life there.
During the trial, someone burned down Ed's house, and when it was brought to his attention, the only thing he said was, "Huh, just as well."
Ed died on July 26, 1984. He was buried in Plainfield Cemetery, but his grave was robbed frequently and eventually stolen. It was recovered in 2001 and now is in a museum. The museum is in Washara County and you can visit it today.
Okay, I am here at the Plainfield Cemetery in Wisconsin. This is the cemetery where Ed Gein is buried. Three very popular horror franchises were, you know, based off this man. So I figured, you know, I took a trip up here. And here is actually where Miss Warden, she was Ed Gein's, you know, final victim before he was arrested. So her stone is right there. May she rest in peace. And I get a marker. This here, the stone between the two trees, Tibbetts. Ed Gein is right across from it. His family's stones. Here, as you can see, this was his brother. Now, he was not convicted of killing his brother, but many believe that he did kill his brother. Yes, this is his brother, Henry Gein. It was mother, Augusta W. Gein. His father, George Gein. Of course, you know, as you may well know, well, if you're a big horror fan or, you know, you're interested in this sort of thing, he loved his mother very much. Of course, when his house was still standing, that was like one of the few rooms in the house that was kept neat when he was arrested. It was practically untouched. Now, his stone actually, I actually believe, someone was saying it was like between like his parents' grave, like maybe down here. I mean, next to his brother would make more sense. Either way, though, the stone is gone. And that's because someone from Seattle, like, stole it. And then they chipped it away and sold parts of it away on eBay, which, you know, that's how he was caught. I believe it was eBay. And what was left of the stone, you couldn't really read anything anymore, unfortunately. So, but as far as I know now, I believe it's in like some museum somewhere. Check out the property. Building up ahead. I'm not sure, so that's just some shed. Yeah, obviously that's not his house. But I'm not sure if that was originally part of the property. That may have been built later. Someone did own the land and the house after he was arrested. I'm not sure if that was built later or not. But again, the actual house is gone. Well, for those of you who don't know, Silence of the Lambs, Texas Chainsaw Massacre, and Psycho are all based off, you know, his actions. I mean, his actions.